My grandmother, she always used to say, the entire life is physics. So as a child who asked those questions and got that as an answer, well, it's physics, that kind of got me interested in the subject, and we would do little experiments in our free time where she would show me how physics can explain stuff like buoyancy, for example. As a child, I really wanted to become a natural scientist because I was very interested in topics such as physics and biology, and I kept asking these questions. Why do stars produce light? Why is space so big? Because it mentions the size of the universe. And yeah, physics and astronomy do try to answer these questions fundamentally. So I was lucky to have really good educators throughout my life. And I was at a high school with a great natural science program and physics teachers that really pushed our interest, and we had active discussions that did not only focus on the lesson plan, but also on just general questions we had. And that really kept me interested and made it seem exciting to go into that direction. Astronomy is so interesting to me because it explains almost everything, but just on a larger picture scale. It's like you zoom out where Earth and our local everyday problems are just a part of this huge machinery within our galaxy and then within a galaxy group. And the further out you go, the more insignificant things become, but we're still part of this entire cycle. I've been very blessed in that sense, that I have had really great support from my family, from educators throughout my school and university life, that have really helped me get where I am today. Because it's not always easy and it's not always as straightforward, and having somebody to back you up in following your dreams is very important. I'm pretty proud of myself for what I achieved so far, and I'm hopefully continuing this path further down and looking into a future to doing research as my career.